Zadwa Wabantu Biography, Family, Age and Dance. Zadwa Wabantu Biography. Zadwa Wabantu, whose real name is Zadwa Rebecca Liebram, is a South African socialite and dancer. She used to work for a debt collection company but later resigned to indulge in the entertainment industry. Zadwa Wabantu career as a dancer. Zadwa became popular for her dance moves at Durban's Iodini Lounge and has since climbed the entertainment ladder. She and her friends used to visit the rock club in Soweto and she became famous for her dance moves. Zadwa is the dancer whose craft in dancing has seen her become one of the most popular and renowned dancers. She works and dances for numerous celebrities, although her closest ties are with Durbanite DJ Dira. Zadwa Wabantu dress. On 1st July at the Vodacom Durban July party held at Greyville Racecourse, Zadwa wore a black figure-hugging dress that had a high slit that left people speechless. The internet went abuzz about the dress since she was pantless and speaking to Soit, and she said she wanted to proudly own the fact that she doesn't wear any underwear, and to flaunt her cellulite with pride. "The inspiration behind it is that I wanted to be sexy and bold," Zadwa explained. "I wanted to show I don't really wear a panty. In the photos my cellulite is clearly visible. I wanted to show women we don't have to hide what we are." According to the Daily Sun, she defended herself and said that she is a role model to a lot of people and claimed that the negative comments would not break her. "People said I was a prostitute and compared my thighs to those of a chicken. But I won't be brought down by those comments. I am a role model for a lot of people. People are able to face their challenges because of the example I set." Wabantu, reputably the most popular and renowned dancers in South Africa, added that behind the dress and her dancing craft was a woman with brains, and she had in fact landed a branding deal with an energy drink company. Zadwa Wabantu charging fee. Zadwa Wabantu charges between R1000 and R1500 for an appearance and a gig. Zadwa Wabantu family. Zadwa Wabantu was orphaned when she was only 9 years old, and she is a mother to one son. Zadwa Wabantu age. Zadwa Wabantu attained the age of 32 years old in 2017. Things you might not know about Zadwa Wabantu. 1. Zadwa Wabantu is a dancer. Dancing is Zadwa Wabantu's claim to fame, and her craft has seen her become one of the most popular and renowned dancers in the country. 2. Zadwa Wabantu is well known in celebrity circles. Zadwa works and dances for numerous celebrities, although her closest ties are with Durbanite DJ Dira. 3. Zadwa Wabantu was never shy about going nude. It's clear that Zadwa is not shy about her body. Perhaps she will give Skolopad a run for her money. 4. Zadwa Wabantu is a proud twerker. With moves like these, she could definitely take on some of the biggest twerkers in the country. 5. Zadwa Wabantu has international connections. Zadwa recently captured herself at the BBC Radio 1 Extra offices, but she wouldn't say who she was accompanying. One thing is certain, she has an extremely strong network. 6. She's a Manchester United fan. While she was in the UK, she paid a visit to the city of Manchester, where she captured a picture of herself outside Old Trafford. 7. She doesn't quite get along with Connie Mbop. Zadwa may have many celebrity friends, but one of them is not Connie Mbop. This comes after it was revealed that Zadwa had a thing with Connie's ex-boyfriend. 8. She's a staunch feminist. While everyone was calling her dress sleazy or slamming her for showing too much skin, Zadwa Wabantu dedicated her controversial outfit to women everywhere. Zadwa Wabantu news. Zimbabwe okays Zadwa Wabantu visit. South African socialite Zadwa Wabantu will not be stopped from coming to Zimbabwe despite a ban imposed on her by the Board of Censors, government disclosed yesterday. This comes after the Board of Censors barred Zadwa from participating in the ongoing Harare International Carnival on the basis that her signature look, short dress with no panties, would violate the country's laws, especially the Censorship and Entertainment Control Act, Chapter 10, 04, Section 16. But in an interview with the Daily News yesterday, Home Affairs Deputy Minister Obiding Wamgyuni said the popular South African socialite won't be barred from entering Zimbabwe. Why should we be concerned about her coming? She has been here in Bulawayo before, and why do you think we should be worried now? He asked. Asked if Sadwa would be allowed to take part in the carnival, Wamgyuni referred his paper to Tourism and Hospitality Industry Minister Walter Mzimbi. If you want to know about whether or not she will perform, then ask Mzimbi, he said. Efforts to get a comment from Mzimbi were fruitless yesterday. His mobile number repeatedly went unanswered. In an interview with a local weekly at the weekend, Mzimbi said Sadwa won't be allowed to take part in the carnival. Her association, directly or indirectly with the Harare International Carnival, a government-conceived and approved branding and entertainment event, means the government is essentially the stage. And by the way, stages are very powerful communication platforms, and therefore we could not be seen promoting how she brands her dancing through nudity or creating peeping toms out of her audiences. Government can't be that big peeping tom or facilitator of such, Mzimbi was quoted as saying. At the weekend, a defiant Sadwa Bantu told a South African newspaper, Sunday Independent, that her trip to Harare was still on. My booking is not cancelled and all my travel arrangements remain the same, she said, adding that she will not change her signature look, which drew the ire of the Board of Censors and Mzimbi. I told them if they want me to wear a covered outfit and panties, then they must buy it for me because I don't have any. I won't change my look just for Zimbabwe. I have so many people who admire me and book me because of my look. Should I change that, I'll lose a lot of money over one gig. I can't risk that. Sadwa Bantu also hit back at former Studio 263 actress Anhira, who successfully appealed to government to ban her from taking part in the ongoing carnival. That woman is talking rubbish. My invite has not been cancelled. In Zimbabwe, it's where I will be on September 7th. I will not be stopped by her jealousy-driven complaint. She is not the one who invited me in the first place. I don't even know why she sticks her nose in my business instead of focusing on herself. There are many Zimbabweans working in South Africa. Why should it be an issue if I am invited to perform there? Said a fuming Sadwa. The larger-than-life South African also expressed her determination to confront Nhira on the matter. I would love to have a word with her about this. She is just jealous of me. She must work hard on her acting career. Maybe she will end up making more money like myself, she said. I'm going to Zimbabwe, says defiant Sadwa Bantu. Durban socialite Sadwa Bantu would not be deterred by a hater who tried to get her banned from attending the Harare International Festival in Zimbabwe this coming Saturday. My booking is not cancelled and all my travel arrangements remain the same, she told our sister paper the Sunday Tribune. This comes after reports that the Zimbabwean Tourism Authority had cancelled her invite to perform at the carnival following comments by a Zimbabwean actress, Anhira, who reportedly complained about the hiring of South African performers for the event when there were many Zimbabweans who were capable of doing the same job. Sadwa dances with no panties and posts naked pictures on social media. How does that qualify her to be a Zimbabwe national tourist attraction and to attend the function of the highest stature this year? She wrote on Facebook. She sparked the social media storm this past week when she claimed that Sadwa's invite had been cancelled. Many accused Nhira of hypocrisy as she had worked in South Africa numerous times without anyone complaining. That woman is talking rubbish. My invite has not been cancelled. In Zimbabwe, it's where I will be on September 7th. I will not be stopped by her jealousy-driven complaint. She is not the one who invited me in the first place, Sadwa said. Sadwa hogged headlines for wearing revealing outfits and going vajayjay al fresco. Her dress at the Durban July drew national attention and boosted her brand, with many event organizers booking her for appearances. I don't even know why she sticks her nose in my business instead of focusing on herself. There are many Zimbabweans working in South Africa. Why should it be an issue if I am invited to perform there? Said a fuming Sadwa. She said, Should she meet Hera, she would confront her. I would love to have a word with her about this. She is just jealous of me. She must work hard on her acting career. Maybe she will end up making more money like myself, she said. There were also reports that Zimbabwean authorities had requested that Zodwa wear underwear when she performs at the carnival, a demand which they have apparently backtracked on. However, Zodwa said she would not change her signature look, which is short dress with no panties, because she would lose a lot of money. I told them if they want me to wear a covered outfit and panties, then they must buy it for me because I don't have any. I won't change my look just for Zimbabwe. I have so many people who admire me and book me because of my look. Should I change that, I'll lose a lot of money over one gig. I can't risk that, she said. Zimbabwe tourism gives in to Zodwa Wabantu's underwear demands. It seems the entertainer will be doing her signature dance moves without underwear on, with the hope that traditional leaders won't be offended. Zimbabwe Tourism Authority CEO Karakaga Kask has reportedly said Zodwa Wabantu can bring her act to Zimbabwe without her panties. Daily Sun reported that Zodwa Wabantu, of Iodini Lounge fame, had been booked to perform in Zimbabwe, but this apparently came with some conservative conditions. She was not too happy with the news. The Zimbabwe Tourism Authority reportedly booked her for a show at a carnival event as the main act, also featuring Babes Wadamo and other stars, in Harare to take place on 6 September, but they wanted her to cover her essentials. The head of corporate affairs for the authority reportedly wanted the entertainer to wear underwear, or they apparently stood the risk of offending chiefs and traditional leaders attending the performance. The authority's chief executive reportedly also told journalists at a press conference in Zimbabwe, "I hope she will have her panties on. If she cannot perform in panties, then we don't want her because chiefs and traditional leaders won't like it." The 32-year-old star was reportedly furious because she was invited to Zimbabwe despite never having made a secret of how she performed in public. "They should have left me alone. I'm really not happy. They are out of their minds," she reportedly said, adding that she felt abused. Now it seems the Zimbabwe Tourism Authority has budged, allowing Zodwa Wabantu to do her signature dance moves without her underwear on. "I would never have compromised because I've worked so hard to build this brand that I am today," she told Daily Sunday Zodwa Wabantu. "People said I was a prostitute. She may not be a singer, an actress or television personality, but Zodwa Wabantu is one of the most popular people in Durban and also on social media." Zodwa first became a sensation when pictures and videos of her dancing at Iodini Lounge in Durban circled social media and she became an overnight star. Zodwa says that despite having become popular, there was a time when people poked fun at her and how she dressed, particularly at how she was dressed last week at the Durban July. "People said I was a prostitute and compared my thighs to those of a chicken. But I won't be brought down by these comments," Zodwa recently told Daily Sunday. Zodwa says she is currently in talks with an energy drink company to become their brand ambassador and she considers herself a role model. "I am a role model for a lot of people. People are able to face their challenges because of the example I set," Zodwa says. Zodwa Wabantu, "I don't feel sexy in panties." Zodwa, popularly known as Zodwa Wabantu, has become one of the main attractions at Iodini Lounge in Umlazi, where she is seen on Sundays in a body-hugging dress without underwear and a savannah in her hand. When the right song comes on, patrons watch in admiration as she shows off her sexy dance moves. Zodwa was raised in Soweto and used to work as a bartender at the Rock Club before she moved to KZN 3 years ago. She told Daily Sun, "I stand out by just being myself. I have no evort makeup. I depend on no man and I don't sleep with men for money. Confidence makes a woman attractive." Zodwa, whose videos and pictures have been causing a stir on social media, has been praised by many for ignoring what others think. But some have bashed her for her dancing and not wearing panties. "Underwear makes me uncomfortable. I don't feel sexy when I'm wearing panties. It's a preference. And people should deal with it. Zadwa Wah Bantu boyfriend. Zadwa previously made headlines for having an affair with Connie Mbaugh's former husband, Manlim Thembu. She was even mentioned in Mbaugh's biography, BH Please. I'm Connie Mbaugh. I didn't even know who Manla was, but he was attracted to me, she said. Zadwa added she owned flats, which she rented out to students. I use my own money. I buy my own booze. I don't go around sleeping with men. Zadwa Wah Bantu Bae's friend Here Is Blood. Zadwa Wah Bantu is baying for actress, and Here Is Blood after she convinced the Zimbabwean government to bar her from performing at the Harare International Carnival, which kicks off today. Zadwa, an entertainer famed for openly stating that she dislikes wearing underwear and her Vasha leg game dance moves, said Mira needed to respect her, especially considering that she was no saint herself. Mira had written to several ministries pleading with them to bar Zadwa from performing at the carnival because of her indecent dressing. She also made it clear that the lump sum being used to pay Zadwa could be used to pay other talented dancers like Bev. Speaking in an interview during the Capitalk Drive show on Wednesday, Zadwa said Nhira needed to know that she had been invited to fulfill the international part of the carnival. I've seen Anne's letter where she's saying I shouldn't come to the carnival because I dress too revealing and that I'm not a Zimbabwean. I want to respond to her saying the invite is not about being Zimbabwean. It's about me being invited to push tourism through dance, music and just having fun so people tolerate each other because we're all different. She urged government to consider lifting the ban because they had no evidence that she does not wear underwear and if not addressed, the issue could cause a rift between Zimbabwe and South Africa. With this thing, we're going to end up fighting and having headaches as there are now mixed feelings between Zimbabweans and South Africans, yet we were now united. I'm Zadwa, an entertainer. Whatever I do is for entertainment. How do they know if I wear a panty or not? I was asked if I wear a panty and I said I don't. If you're saying you're not going to have me at the carnival, how are you going to see that I don't wear a panty because a panty is under my dress? Whether I'm wearing it or not, how are you going to prove it? It's a bad move and I hope the government there rethinks it. I want to advise them that I'm not coming there for the money as I'm fully booked all over the world, but to entertain people there and push tourism. If you don't allow me into Zimbabwe, look at the message you'd have sent out there. This will put fear in others from South Africa as they'll think that they're not wanted there, killing tourism. She further questioned why government had entertained a complaint from a person who does not reside in the country and is actually based in South Africa, looking for greener pastures. How can government listen to one asked lady who's not in Zimbabwe, but resides in South Africa where she's trying to make a better life for herself? Brazilians dress worse than me, but the carnival is all about bringing countries together. To Anne, Zadwa said she needed to get to know her first before judging her. Who the H is Anne to tell me where I must not go or who I shouldn't interact with? She needs to hear me talk, feel my mind and she'll definitely be surprised. We've so many issues as women and I'm here to stand up for them. Anne is fake, wears fake hair, fake makeup and fake nails. Everything about her is fake. She says on her social media pages, she's a slay queen, but we don't need queens but real people like Zadwa. Her life is not real, it's fake, so I don't support her since she's not supporting me. Women are jealous of one another and it's sad. Questioned if she was going ahead with her trip to Harare, Zadwa said she was confused as she is getting mixed signals concerning her Harare performance. Other than the carnival appearance during the street party on September 9, Zadwa is meant to perform at the private lounge on September 8. Yesterday, the people responsible for my Harare booking called asking me to send my passport details in order for them to book my flight to Harare. Today they responded via email telling me that my performance there is still on. It's the social media stuff and newspaper articles that government has banned me from performing there that's confusing me, said Zadwa. Earlier yesterday, she however, sent a poster detailing her performance at private lounge as if to confirm her appearance there. Zodwa Bantu's trip to Zimbabwe. Born Rebecca Zodwa Libram, Zodwa Bantu, who was on a partying spree around Africa, made her maiden visit to Bulawayo, where she mixed and mingled with her local fans. Oversubscribed might be the best word to describe the club's night's attendance, which, by no doubt, harvested more revelers over other night spots in the city. Clad in a skimpy black dress that revealed her thunder thighs, Zodwa's grand entrance around midnight, making her way to the VIP arena, set an already rocking club on fire. At the VIP arena she was joined by friends, local socialites and her local imitator, Trino Bambino, real name Trinity Sabanda, who had won the competition for being the best imitator. Unlike at other shows where Zodwa would join the crowds in dance and take pictures with her followers, Club Connect was oversubscribed that it was difficult to find space for one to move. The best that Zodwa could do was periodically dance from the VIP arena throughout the night, as the crowd watched from a distance through the smoke, which was gunned from the club's smoke machines. Some people came as far as Harare only to get a glimpse of the woman with no panties getting down to combeats with a bottle covering her arsenal, but that did not happen, as there was no space among the crowd to fit Zodwa's thighs. The only free space was the VIP arena, which also proved to be too small for the energetic dancer. However, Zodwa said out of all her tours, Zimbabwe stood out of the rest. Upon her arrival at the Joshua Mkabukunkamo Airport at 1 p.m. on Saturday, Zodwa visited Kilumane 12's Komkombo the Sports Bar, where she met with her fans for a break, before she rocked Club Connect at night. Braving the cold weather, Zodwa came dressed in a body-hugging backless dress which left little to the imagination. The Mzansi socialite, who has made headlines for attending parties and shows without panties, enjoyed the cozy ghetto vibes in Kilumane. "I am enjoying being a cozy, this is so real and the love from fans is real. I am getting to meet the people personally. Zimbabwe has brought exciting moments, I will definitely come back if I get an opportunity to," she said. "I have never had such an encounter, from the airport to the club. Zimbabwe is too nice and people here know how to party, I would do this again." Being Zodwa Bantu. Near naked provocateur Zodwa Bantu has captured the world's attention ever since her revealing dress she wore at the socialite event of the year, the Durban July, which made her an overnight sensation. Robert Mukandwa made the trek to Bulawayo to meet the socialite and get a glimpse into her lifestyle. When word got round that Bulawayo's Club Connect would be hosting Zodwa Rebecca Liam, popularly known as Zodwa Bantu, little did the proprietor Biggie Chinoperi Kwee know that he had attracted attention across the nation. Many packed their bags from as far as Harare to see the socialite sensation, who in all essence is famous for being famous. At the Durban July this year, in a skimpy outfit, Zodwa Bantu had captured South Africa and the world's attention by dressing in a revealing outfit and no underwear, in scenes that went viral around the world. In no time at all, having Zodwa just grace your event meant she would walk away with at least 25,000 rands no less. And so it happened that on a very chilly July morning the socialite touched down at the Joshua Mkabukunkamo International Airport in Bulawayo to grace an event at the premier Club Connect and do what she knows best, be famous. Welcomed by the notorious Alteza crew that had traveled at speeds of up to 180 kilometers per hour with this reporter, adrenaline was soaring and Zodwa, with her skimpy outfits, was set to cause a rush of blood to the head. Any head imaginable on the human body. Zodwa Bantu did not disappoint. While the gods were sending cold spittle onto the earth, one would have thought Zodwa would finally wear underwear and something warm. But any bookmaker who bet on that certainly lost on the day. Not even the cold could get her to wrap herself in warmth as she emerged with a lace black number little more than a belt size that revealed her caramel-colored canvas of skin spread out like a buttery veneer. "Why does she not wear under?" I quizzed her when we finally got to one-on-one. "It does not make me comfortable," was her sure-shot answer. "I am me. A woman, and I know who I am. I do not need to have underwear or other people to define me." I am comfortable without underwear and that is the way I will stay, she boldly declared without thinking twice. Zadwa Bantu went on to challenge me to go at least a week without wearing the same. I obliged, and failed. But perhaps the most unnerving is how tens of men made the journey from all around the country to go and see her over that weekend. She is a phenomenon and we all want to get to see someone who turns heads like that. She has a sort of allure that men want and look for, said one of the men who traveled to Bulawayo to see Zadwa in the flesh as it were. She doesn't wear makeup and sometimes we want that in a person. A real person with reality we can see, he added. And carnally hungry eyes licked her skin everywhere she went as she caused traffic jams and moist eyes whilst mixing and mingling with the crowds in Bulawayo's central business district while the Altezza crew sent their car horns crazy. The beauty of Zadwa is that she does not show us everything and kind of teases us men. Men like to be teased and that is why I am here. To see her toy with people's emotions, said Alfred, who was coy about giving out his second name. My wife thinks I have gone for a work convention, he confided in me much like a devout Catholic may confide to his priest in confessional. There was something that her outfit said to people who looked at her as Alfred said. Something that did indeed toy with people's emotions. Something that said look but don't touch, touch but don't taste, taste but don't swallow. Something like the forbidden fruit in the center of the Garden of Eden. This is immoral, said a lone voice in the wilderness. But that voice was the exception not the rule. The rest of the people were terribly happy to meet and touch Zadwa. Touch her in a dignified way however. Zadwa Bantu took selfies with adoring masses. Mothers, sisters, brothers, friends and little boys. All who could see through her lace to her rather intimate geolocations. She didn't mind. She also didn't mind that people say she looks like Gringo Lazarus Maura, a man. He was there to welcome her. They were separated at birth, claim malicious people who see them. Yet she embraces him and smiles and says she gets that a lot, being told she looks like a man. I am a person who comes from the people. I am owned by the people. I am not a show-offer. That is why I am called Zadwa Bantu. Zadwa, owned by the people, she later said. And yet of course she shows of some things to be honest. And in the evening at the event she crawled into a few bits of fabric and attended the event at Club Connect. It was epic how people turned out just for her. The lady with fabric on her body. Club Connect was packed to the rafters. Then they actually had to build new rafters and it became packed to those two. All for the socialite who does nothing but feed visual carnal desires. And after speaking to the crowd, revealing herself and blowing a few kisses to the people after a mock dance, her event and her act was done and that was money in the bank. Just like that. Next I want to come to Harare, she boldly declared after giving me a hug at the end of the interview. I could smell that realness the cinnamon scent on her skin with no Givenchy scent and the velvety canvas that covers her as skin. Either I give such good hugs she wanted to follow me to Harare. That, or the simple fact that when she comes to Harare she has to be paid another 25,000 rands to appear. And who wouldn't want to come to Harare when they are paid that much? In fact, who would decline a visit to war in Afghanistan if they are to be paid such an amount to appear? Zadwa Bantu broke the bank and revealed a new trend. That without makeup and with little more than a meter of fabric, you can become a big celebrity no less. And now for Zadwa Bantu, Harare awaits. It was overwhelming the response we got, says Biggie, we shall certainly do it again.